Okay. Mickey always wins anyway. I think this game is fair.
Your cousin wouldn't do a thing like that, would he?
I don't know. Next time I'm going to bring over my own game.
Goodbye, sweetheart.
Come on,
bye.
Mama, speak to you later.
Bye. Drive carefully.
You will.
Hey, Kevin, what's the good word?
Don't play games with Mickey. You lose everything you've got.
I'll bear that in mind. Where'd you get candy?
Oh, it's a long story.
Popeye.
Who's there?
Oh, it's just me, Mrs. Brady.
Oh, come on in, Alice. I'm in the kitchen. Hi.
Hi.
You know, I don't mind putting these real estate flyers in the envelopes, but I sure hate licking this glue.
Can I give you a hand or a tongue?
Oh, pull up a chair, please.
This is what I wanted to talk to you about. Real estate.
Can I help you with something?
It looks like we're putting Sam's Butcher Shop up for sale.
After all these years?
Mm-hmm. And we wanted to go through you.
Oh, I'd be delighted to help.
We don't own the property, but we want to put the lease on the store up for sale.
Well, it's in a good location. I'm sure I can find you a customer. What's Sam planning to do?
He's going to retire. Last, after all these years, we're going to spend every day together.
Oh, congratulations, Alice. That sounds great.
Mrs. Brady, I am so happy. I am so happy. I'm having trouble talking.
I understand. All that happiness.
No, it's all this darn glue.
Okay, establish.
E-S-T... A, B, L, I, F, E.
Yes! Ah, okay. Technique. Sound it out.
E, E, C.
Nora.
Peter.
Hi. Kevin, give me five.
Hi, Uncle Peter.
How you doing?
Hey.
Is Greg ready?
Well, you bet he is. Parents' night at Kevin's school is the highlight of the whole semester, right?
Parents' night?
Yeah. Greg?
Yeah.
Peter's here.
Yeah, Greg, I know I'm early, but I thought we could grab some cheeseburgers. It's a little breezy. You'll need this.
Early?
Greg, it's Friday. We're going to the Laker game. What is this about parents' night?
The game. Oh, no. I completely forgot.
Oh. Well, that's all right. Nora can take Kevin, right? I mean, it's a little b-ball, the Laker girls. It's boys' night out. Let's hit the road.
Peter, I don't think I can.
Oh, Greg, come on. We've had this planned for over a couple weeks.
Peter, parents' night has been planned a lot longer than that.
Can't you do it?
We both should be there. Kevin's having a little trouble with his spelling.
Yes, like words. Like technique. Show Uncle Peter how you spell it.
P-E-C-H-N-I-Q-U-E.
So what am I supposed to do, go alone?
Can't you get a date?
That's not the point.
Peter, come on, there'll be other games.
Yeah, right. You know, you made a commitment to me. And this isn't the first time you've done this. Remember when you were supposed to go water skiing and you bailed out on that? You know, and come to
Peter,
dinner,
but maybe someday you're going to find out life has certain responsibilities.
What is that supposed to mean in reference to me?
Okay, well, I think that we should go upstairs and get ready so we don't have to come
in. Can't we stay and watch him fight?
Move it.
Oh, Peter, you're a bachelor. You got lots of friends you can go out with. Let's face it, you don't have much to worry about. Listen, Greg, just because I don't have a wife and a child doesn't mean I don't have responsibilities. And those responsibilities don't keep me from having fun.
I had fun.
No, you don't.
I do, too.
No, you don't. I have fun. No, you don't. Not like we used to.
If I had fun like we used to, Nora would be looking for a good lawyer.
Just because you become a family man doesn't mean that you suddenly have a monopoly on rewarding experiences. And it doesn't mean that you automatically become a boring stiff.
That's enough.
Yeah, sure is.
Come on in.
Thanks. Grab a chair. I'll be in just a minute here. seem a little edgy.
Oh, well, I kind of have something on my mind. See, Mike, I wanted to ask you a favor. It's not really a favor. It's more of a business proposition.
What's on your mind?
Well, as you know, I've lost a few jobs lately, and I thought about trying my luck in the business world.
What'd you come up with?
Okay, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
PR. Public relations. It's a perfect field for me. You know, I was born to do it. You know, whenever I watch commercials on TV, I always know what they're going to say next. And you know what? I've got the perfect name for my company. Wally Logan Public Relations.
You don't think you'd like to take a job at a public relations firm first?
But see, I've got all these ideas. All I need is a silent partner. I'm not very strong in that area yet.
Being silent?
It means that. Well, you know, funding, you know, financial seeding, you know, that's where you come in.
I'd like to see you get back on your feet. That's for sure. Now, Wally, if you're talking about a loan, I'd have to speak with Carol first. Because our savings partly come from what she makes in real estate.
No, I understand that.
Well, I'll tell you what. You give us some time to think about it. But don't bank on it.
Sorry. Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Put the chair.
Oh, yeah.
Back over there.
Bye.
Bye.
You know, Marcia's been looking for something she can really get into, and so have I, and I think I've got it. Remember my cousin in Dayton?
Bonnie.
Louise. Bonnie's my cousin in Akron.
Right, the one with the catering business.
Louise has the catering business. Bonnie's a dermatologist.
I thought Lisa was a dermatologist.
Bonnie and Lisa are both dermatologists. Anyway, Louise has been very successful, and I think that's something Marcia would really enjoy doing.
Dermatology?
No, catering. Marcia's a wonderful cook, and I have a business background, and I think it might work out very nicely. Here, wait. Try this hors d'oeuvre.
You know, I think you'll do even better than your cousin.
Really?
You're going to make a great dermatologist.
Why, Ayana? Orange columns show purchase of food at wholesale rates. Now, the blue is utility expenses, and in the green, it's uniform laundry by the month. The pink, total expenses. Now, here we have the figures for gross and net profits for the year, broken down to the month and the week.
Boy, Tracy, you really did some research.
This is just my cousin's business. I've also got the figures for four other catering services. Bobby's a whiz with that computer.
Oh, I think you've given us enough information for now.
And what do you think?
Well, certainly seems to be merit to the idea.
Just how much backing are we talking about?
I estimate we can have the whole thing in place and ready to go for $30,000.
$30,000?
Boy, that's a lot of chopped liver.
According to my cousin, if we can just do three parties a week, we can repay the entire loan in 1 year.
We're going to be doing all the cooking and all the work ourselves.
And that'll keep our overhead down.
Well, we have a lot to talk over here.
Yeah, why don't you give us a day or two to think it over?
Please, take whatever time you need, Dad.
Nice work, ladies.
Mom.
We'd give you a business card, but we don't have a business yet.
Yes.
We're great.
Keep your fingers crossed.
I think we have a shot.
Bye-bye, Wally.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Good night, Martha.
Bye.
Bye.
Well?
I think they liked it.
Yeah, well, if you want my advice, don't count your crab puffs.
Oh, I tell you, it would be so nice if those three girls could work together.
Yeah, but if we loan them the money, how's Wally going to feel?
Well, Marcia's going to be in the business. That would be helping Wally, wouldn't it?
It's not the same thing, you know that.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Well, it's a tough problem.
I just hope we can solve it before it causes a problem between Marcia and Wally.
Hi,
We came up with a really good idea.
You think that the party girls could be a very promising investment.
But you know what a catering business needs as well as good food and good service? Someone to put them on the map. Let people know about them.
Like PR.
Exactly. Otherwise, you just get lost in the shuffle.
So, we're ready with a loan if you can find somebody to do the PR work.
Well, you're right. PR is essential.
Yeah.
So you don't get lost in the shuffle.
Well, then, how about it, Wally? You want to join the girl?
I'd love to join the girl.
Here is to Wally for putting this celebration together.
Yay!
This is kind of a cake breaking, so to speak, for a new business that we hope is a resounding success.
We were thinking of asking Sam and Alice about buying the lease to Sam's butcher shop.
Sold.
Just like that?
I can't think of anybody I'd rather sell it to than the Bradys.
Fair price.
I'm not worried. I happen to have a very sharp real estate agent.
On my honor, I will do my duty to be fair and earn my commission.
You know, the shop already has sinks and a freezer. It will be real easy to redesign. I can help you there.
Oh, listen, ladies, if you need any help, just let me know.
Thank you.
Okay, Peter.
Sure you want to? It's only family.
I know. Well, how about you? You think you can tear yourself away from the PTA?
Cheap shot.
So?
Look, Peter, not here. You're the mature one, I forgot.
Are you two having a problem?
That's a great idea. Is there any cake left?
Yeah, but we ate all the icing.
What? That's the best part!
Just kidding.
Don't fool me like that. Grandpa, you had a phone call before.
I did? When?
I think it was before I went outside.
Who was it?
I think he said Mr. Paisner or Mr. Wilson, something like that.
Was it Mr. Bartholomew?
That could have been it. I told Mickey to let me get it.
Do you leave a number? What do you want?
But I don't know who called. How could I know what he wanted?
Now, listen, mister. This is about the fifth time you've done that. Mickey, don't you answer the phone if you don't know how to do it. Now, it could have been important. You understand that?
Sorry, Grandpa.
Mickey, come get your cake.
No, thanks.
Mick?
Grandpa?
Yes?
Why don't you like me?
What makes you say that?
Well, you're always telling me I'm doing something wrong.
Come here a minute. Come on. Come up here. Now listen. I don't just like you. I love you. I will always love you. No matter what you do.
No matter what?
No matter what.
Even if I dropped your toothbrush in the toilet?
You didn't do that, did you?
No.
Even if you dropped my toothbrush in the toilet. Okay? Now listen. Answering the telephone is a real responsibility. Because you may have to take a message for whomever it's for. You want to know how to do that?
Uh-huh.
Okay. You know how to print, right? Ask who it is. And you write down their name. Ask them how to spell it if you have to. Ask for the phone number. And you write that down. Then you ask if there's any message. And you write that down. You think you can handle that?
Sure.
Are you sure you're sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's go get some cake.
I love you too, Grandpa.
Come on.
I'll get it.
No, let Mickey get it.
Grandpa get real.
I know what to do.
You know, he always gets it messed up. He once took a message from me, and he got it all wrong.
I hope it wasn't urgent.
It was. Jennifer said that Joey liked Erica. Catch down.
That's perfect, Mickey. That's perfectly done. Everything is here. But the call is for me. Why didn't you just give me the phone?
He told me to write it all down.
Go get your cake.
Come on. Well, Jan, what do you think?
I haven't seen a sink like this since before I was born.
Oh, I don't know.
Hi.
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 Sorry for me.
You know, it just doesn't seem the same without those pork loins hanging around.
But Sam sure was eager to retire. He had this place packed up in a day and a half. I'm going to check out the freezer.
This place is perfect for us.
What do you think, Jim? I think that there's a lot here, there's a lot you can do, and it shouldn't take very long.
Is the freezer working?
Answers my question.
Well, the phones are here. Let's start cleaning.
Jan, they're going to need storage space. They're going to need an area to cook in, an area to reheat in, and also an office area.
Yeah, well, I'll start some sketches. It shouldn't be too much construction.
And we can all pitch in. Maybe we can get the boys to help. Greg, Peter.
Oh, you're not going to get Greg and Peter together at the same time.
What is the matter with those boys anyway?
I don't know. It's some kind of misunderstanding. I'm sure they'll work it out.
I have never seen them snipe at each other like they did the other night.
Well, at least then they were talking to each other. Now they're avoiding each other completely.
Well, guys, it's 2:30, and I have to get back to the office, so I'll call you.
Bye.
Oh, I have to pick Kevin up at 3.
You know, Mickey and Jessica are through at 3, too.
It'll be a heck of a way to run a business.
Hi.
We'll work something out.
We will. I can stick around for a while.
Yeah, all your kids are grown up.
Sometimes I wonder. And that was a moldy oldie for you codgers out there with working memories. Hey, having a party this weekend? Forget the chips and dips and frozen weenies, unless that's your guest list. Feed those people right. Let the Party Girls whip up something special. The Party Girls Catering Service. Superfood at mild-mannered prices. Call the Party Girls if you're having an affair. Who knows? You might be hungry afterwards. The Party Girls, grand opening tomorrow. Call 555-DIPS.
Cue that.
Thanks. I'll tell Wally. And thank you again for the great deal on the rate.
Maybe later we can clinch the deal.
What kind of a clinching are you referring to?
Holding hands under the table during dinner at Lucino's.
Sounds promising. But what about Carly and Jake?
I don't ask my kids who I can take to dinner. You want to know why?
Why?
Because they tell me.
Good reason.
Yeah, 7 o'clock.
Okay, see you later.
Okay.
I know mothers are not supposed to interfere, but we do anyway.
Ma, it's no biggie. Things will work out.
I know they will, but you're brothers. You're supposed to love each other.
Oh. Really? What a novel approach. I thought that only happened on the Waltons.
Peter, what happened between you two, anyway?
Nothing much. Just, Greg and his self-righteous self.
Why don't you give him a call? I'm sure he'd love to hear from you.
No, I doubt it, Mom.
Well, you won't know until you try it.
Look, Mom, he's the one who messed things up. He should call me.
It doesn't matter who calls who. The important thing is that you two talk and get past this. Otherwise, it'll just get worse.
No, it's not worth it.
Peter. It is worth it.
Oh, look, Mom, it's probably too late. I mean, all responsible family men get to bed at 8:30 now, don't they?
Come on, Peter. Do it for me, your old mother.
I'm just kidding. Just kidding.
You better be.
I'll do it. Busy. He's probably explaining Little League rules to the other daddies.
This is Peter. Sorry I'm not in. At the sound of the beep, please leave your name and number, and I'll get back to you.
Figures. It's his machine again. He's probably out with Debbie or Cindy or Mindy or some other E.
Not necessarily. Come on, don't be so quick to judge him.
When you don't have a home, why stay home?
Would you please just try him later?
Yeah. Maybe next September. Right now, I think I'm going to go to bed and get a good night's sleep. Kevin's Little League team is facing the Tornadoes tomorrow, and they're tough.
You guys are so close. Why are you taking a chance on ruining this relationship? I bet that's Peter.
No way. Hello?
Hi, Greg.
It's Peter. It's about time.
Oh, give me a break.
You know, I've been trying to reach you for a couple of hours.
I thought you might be interested in.
But it seems your social life and your dating are so important, you're never home.
Well, you just can't stand the fact that I might be having fun now, can you?
Yeah, and you're right. I'm not at home.
I'm at Mom and Dad's because Mom thought my relationship with you was worth saving.
That is not exactly what I had in mind.
Like I said before, Mother should never interfere.
You should have listened to yourself.
What?
Mm. 9 a.m. Congratulations, ladies. We are now in business.
Yes, great.
Ooh, what is this?
Oh, now stop with your samples for customers. Mm.
Think of it as an executive perk. Should be stock options.
This is so exciting.
You know, with the ads, flyers, and radio spots, business should really get bustling.
Now, don't expect too much business on the first day. My cousin says it takes a while to catch on.
Do you think we should get some extra phone lines?
Wally, so far these haven't rung yet.
Right. Ooh. What did he say?
Yes, we do any kind of party, anywhere, just like any other caterer. But quite honestly, with a lot better food. Oh, yes, I'm sure we can find time to fit you into our busy schedule. No, thank you. Why does everyone have to think about it?
Okay.
So far we have 12, think about it. 8 maybes, 9 absolutely not. 18, I thought this was Sam's butcher shop.
Okay, it's the first day. We knew it would be slow.
Yeah, but what is slow after me? Nobody.
Maybe this isn't gonna work.
Oh, now stop getting so down, you guys.
I think that we should just take one day at a time. Be hungry? Good.
One thing about the catering business, you always have something to eat.
Mm. Oh,
Marsha, this is good.
I mean, the thing is, it's really hard to attract customers when nobody knows anything about us.
Well, hey, don't look at me. I mean, look, I squeeze every penny out of our advertising budget.
We obviously need more.
How? I mean, we don't have the money for TV coverage or leaflets dropped from crop dusters. Yeah, I'll tell you what we need. We need a hook.
What do you mean, a hook?
You know, something different, something that'll attract attention, like if aliens were at the parties.
Wait a minute. Wally's right. Your parties need to have a gimmick or a theme. About a month ago, your father and I went to a party that had a Hawaiian motif. Everything. The decor, the costumes, the food. They had orchid lays and hula lessons. Oh, you should have seen your father. No, really, it was a lot of fun.
Well, I think you're onto something here. There's, like, endless possibilities, right? We could do Western and Oriental, Spanish, French.
Yeah, easy.
We could make a whole production out of it, you know, with props and costumes. And
I can go to the library and get some international cookbook.
Yeah, oh, you know, this would be great. It would spice up the ads. You know, the radio spots on Cindy's show?
That's good. That's the plan. First.
first thing in the morning, we get to work.
All right.
Let's sleep on it.
I'm going to be in the morning.
Yeah, really, it was funny when we got up and we all did it.
Oh,
you and Peter must have been so cute together.
Yeah, we had some fun. I remember one time. In fact, I just about taught Peter everything.
Mm-hmm. Hello, lovely one.
Peter? Is that you?
Yeah. Could I talk to you? It's important.
I guess so. Come around to the front.
No, wait.
I see you here, where your lovely hair outshines the moonbeams.
I want to see you here, where your lovely hair outshines the moonbeams.
Peter, are you feeling okay?
How could I feel otherwise when I'm so close to your beauty?
How could I feel otherwise when I'm so close to your beauty?
I've never seen you act like this before.
I'm not acting. It's true love from the first time I saw you.
I'm not acting. It's true love from the first time I saw you.
Peter, why are you standing all the way over there?
Why am I standing over here?
Distance lends enchantment.
Distance lends enchantment? What in the world is going on out there?
Just take what I have to offer. The rainbows, the sunlight, my life, the world.
Take my rainbows and sunlit life.
That's not what I said.
Sunlit rain, rain, rain.
Now, quiet out loud, will you?
That was a long time ago.
Doesn't have to be.
I think it does.
Please, Greg, don't give up on him.
I don't know what else to do.
Well, you've got to do something. I mean, otherwise it's going to go from bad to worse and it's going to explode into something awful.
But you're being a little dramatic.
Well, no, I don't think so. It could happen. Look, it happened in the tightest of families. What about Cain and Abel?
Right. If only Cain and Abel had gone to that basketball game.
You know what I mean. Look, I know you'd be happier if things were back the way they were.
It doesn't seem to matter to him.
Come on, reach out to him. Do something really nice.
I'll think about it.
Well, yes, Mom, we'd love to. Yes, we can sleep you in, but I'm serious. You can't believe how busy things have gotten.
Well, yeah, we have Bobby and Peter here helping us out.
Yes, of course I've seen Greg. I sleep with him. But no, he hasn't been here.
Okay, bye. Ma!
Thank you. We're going to do a business party for Dad.
Oh, that's great.
It's in honor of a visiting ambassador or a council or something. They're going to let us know what country.
We are so booked up. I just hired 2 extra waiters.
Incredible. We already need staff.
And when the creature with the huge head hopped forward, Billy and Wendy backed up. But there was a wall. And the wall was 8 feet tall and slippery. Very slippery. Uh-oh, what are they gonna do next?
Come on in, Alice.
Well, I know you weren't expecting me tonight, Mrs. Brady, but I just didn't know where to go. I had to get out of my house.
Well, out of your house?
Yeah, it's Sam. He's driving me straight to the funny farm.
I thought you two were looking forward to spending time together.
Well, we were. But after only 3 weeks, he doesn't know what to do with himself. And no matter where I go, he's there. I go to sit in a chair, he's there. I go to take a bath, he's there. He fires his way through daytime TV like the remote was a machine gun. I don't know how much you need your peace and quiet until it's suddenly gone.
Well, you two just have to spend time in different places.
Well, if his place is in the house, my place is somewhere in Tahiti.
Alice, I have an idea that might help you out. Nora and I are going to have a tough time running a business with the kids to watch after school. I mean, Jan has to juggle Patty sometimes. It would be great if we had someone we could trust with them until we got home.
Sort of a Brady daycare center starring Alice?
Right, and you'd be helping me out, too. I mean, I'll be so busy at the real estate office.
What do you think, kids?
Yeah!
When do I start?
Hi, everybody.
Hey, Greg.
Hi, honey.
Hi, Pete.
Greg.
Look, I think we should talk.
Yeah? So talk.
Maybe privately.
Come on, over here.
The freezer?
Maybe they'll chill out a little.
This is a great idea. Well, look, it's the only place we can be in private.
Well, are you going to talk or are we going to freeze to death?
All right. Look, I've been feeling bad about the way things are between us.
Yeah, well, I haven't felt great about it either.
Good.
Well, anyway, I was trying to think of a way we could patch things up. And, well, here.
All right, Greg, Lakers Celtic tickets, Magic versus Bird.
Yeah,
right.
We're gonna make up for the game we didn't get to.
Well, thanks, Greg.
Yeah.
Well, wait a minute. Are these next Saturday?
Yeah, Saturday at 8.
Oh, Greg, I've got a problem.
What?
Well, you see, I've been invited out to this party in Malibu on Saturday night, and there's gonna be these twins there that I've wanted to meet, Carrie and Terry.
You got you to give up the game for twins?
Yeah.
Doesn't it mean anything to you at all that I'm trying to clean things up between us?
Well, yeah, sure it does, Greg, but they're twins.
Look, there's plenty of other games. We can go to the Bulls game. We don't have tickets for the Bulls game, Peter. Look, did you stop and think about what I had to do to get those tickets? How long I had to wait in line? The fact that I had to take time off of work? Or how much they cost? You know, I didn't...
All right, how much were they? I'll pay you back for
them. This has got nothing to do with money. You just don't get it, do you?
Yeah, I get it, Greg. You have no clue that other people might have different priorities than your own.
I guess they're working things out. Thank God.
This has to do with me going out of my way to try and save our relationship.
Save our relationship, Greg? By what? Buying me tickets? All you had to do was apologize.
Apologize for what?
You really don't know, do you? Thank God there's no law that says just because someone was born your brother, you have to like them.
That's a lot of gratitude I get for everything I've done for you.
Well, Greg, all that you've done for me was be a role model for someone I don't want to be. Well, believe me, growing up around you is not like a day at Disneyland.
You're jealous.
That's what it is. You're jealous.
You're jealous because I'm a doctor. I have a beautiful wife, a nice home, a pension.
I'm not jealous, Greg. And just because I don't have an MD or a wife and a child to parade around at parents' night or a beautiful pension doesn't mean that I'm a failure.
It's not me calling you a failure, Peter. Don't blame me if you've messed up your whole life.
Greg, here are your precious tickets. Why don't you just take them?
Stop it! Peter, wait!
Wait a minute!
No.
Hey,
come on!
What is wrong with you two?
From now on, pal, you don't even exist.
That's the best news I've had all day.
Molly brought the first load already.
Oh, my feet hurt.
What?
The first load?
Oh, but
I'm so happy.
Ladies, may I present...
Da-da-da-da-da-da!
The check! Oh, our first check!
I don't believe this night. It went so smoothly.
A Roman toga party, no problem. Just make a bunch of pasta, walk around, say, you know... Hey!
Hey, I didn't know you spoke Latin.
Hey, for the water.
Caterer's work is never done.
How did we get this many dishes?
The food was just too good. They kept coming back for more, which is why it's time for you girls to wash the dishes.
At least we don't have to roll up our sleeves.
Hey, you, get over here.
Hey, you know what? We booked another party for next weekend, and wait till you hear this.
a little mermaid party.
Mermaid costume?
That should keep us hopping.
Oh, no.
Just when you thought it was safe to come out of the water.
Party girl, fantasies come true. You dream it up, we'll make it happen. The only limitation is your imagination. Which brings us to the musical question, rap on, brother, they're eating us alive.
I just wanted to let you know, the station got a check from the party girls.
Thanks, Gary. I'm really glad for the girls. They've really taken off.
It's the power of our advertising.
In fact, they're catering a party for my dad and some foreign dignitaries on Friday. You want to be my date?
Great. I'll wear something foreign.
King Adams was going across the drawbridge.
Gwendolyn's got to get to the moat. Gwendolyn, get to
the dragon.
Oh, you got me again.
I warned you. Are you sure you don't want to play for peppermint?
If we play for anything, it's going to be carrot sticks.
Yeah, carrot sticks are healthy. Can I get it? I know what to do.
Okay, go ahead.
It better not be for me. When can you play house? I hate playing house with Mickey. He cheats. You can't keep playing house. Mickey can.
That was quick.
That was a quick message from Grandpa's office for my mom.
Tuesday?
That's when Grandpa's guests are coming.
Carlisle?
That's where they're staying.
Austria?
That's where they come from.
Wunderbar.
No, that's not it at all. Ricky and I just can't make it tonight.
You know, sure, it's tough being a vice president.
There are three other big parties tonight, and all our usual waiters are booked.
Oh, where are we going to find two waiters?
This is where having a big family comes in handy.
What, are you going to draft Bradys?
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Brady's office.
Dr. Brady, please.
One moment.
Especially two brothers who are going to find themselves working together.
Dr. Brady?
Greg? We desperately need help for the party tonight.
I'm better at appendectomies than hors d'oeuvres.
Oh, Greggy.
You do have a way with words.
What do you call him, Your Majesty?
Well, I don't know. He's Austrian, so maybe mein Herr.
Oh, your hair is fine, huh?
No, not my hair. Mein Herr. We'll have to ask your grandpa. What do you think? You're doing great.
4 years as a college hasher leaves its mark.
Mm. So, when does Dad get here?
Oh, he's going to be soon. He went right from the office to the airport.
Terrific decor.
Oh, thank you. We worked so hard.
You should need light beer to sign that heavy, huh?
Very nice. Signs aren't typically Austrian. They're far more indigenous to Bavaria. But it's very nice.
Oh, here we go. Okay, as long as you're ready to report for duty.
I should have known he was going to be here.
Come on, it's not so bad. But hey, look at this. Look what you got to wear. Greg, this is ridiculous.
Right, he should have stayed home.
We needed you both. You're both here. Now, can't you tell a truth? At least for tonight.
It's not up to me.
No, it's up to both of you. You don't want to embarrass Dad in front of his guests, do you?
Have an hors d'oeuvre. You've been such a help. Thank you. It's really great.
Peter?
Peter, look! Oh, Peter, look! Help! What's the matter?
Peter, are you okay?
He's choking!
Greg, he's choking. I don't know. Can you breathe?
No,
all right, now calm down. I'm going to do the Heimlich.
Let Greg help you, Peter. Drop your hand. Peter, drop.
Let me help you.
Greg, go.
I got it.
Oh, Peter! Greg, is he all right? Somebody call 911.
Is there a doctor here?
He's a doctor.
The waiter's a doctor?
All right. Oh.
Oh. I didn't know you cared.
I didn't either.
Peter, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. It's kind of scary. I guess you saved my life.
Just don't hold it against me.
Take it easy, Peter. Nice work.
Peter, you okay?
Greg, I blew up the other day and I said some things that I
look, we each have our own lives and they're different. There's nothing wrong with that.
Right, but friends come and go and brothers are forever.
It's really corny, Peter.
So soon.
Oh, it is really good to see you two getting along again.
You're getting along? I think Peter wants to go steady.
Peter, I was so scared.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? It has been my very great pleasure already to have officially welcomed to our city, and now to present to you the Honorable Graham Riley, Her Majesty's Envoy from the Commonwealth of Australia, and Mrs. Riley. Australia, not Austria.
Nice going, Mickey. That was close.
Australia! Australia! Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun. May I say that it's quite a delight spending this time here in your country, a land of many novel surprises. It's come as quite a surprise and quite a relief, too, I might say. After being greeted everywhere we go with g'day, mate, and put another shrimp on the barbie, this is quite refreshing. And I must say that we really are looking forward to spending a night in the Alps.
You're really lucky, Mickey. You got it.
Okay. All right.
Like Greg and Peter are pals again.
Right.
Well, I knew it. What happened?
They kissed and made up.
That's what happened. I'll explain it to you later.
Okay, we have to keep track. Der Stein, because they have to be back by 5:00.
Well, you know, these are really Bavarians.
All right. Hey, congratulations on another successful party. You know, this party really was a success for everyone.
All around. Looks like you gals have got a real thriving little business going here.
A little too thriving.
We just can't operate out of such a little place like Sam's Butcher Shop anymore. Alice, we need a bigger place.
Wonderful. Wonderful? Well, Alice, you're going to have to find someone else to take over the lease.
So Sam and I have been driving each other loony around the house. I've decided it's time he went back to work at Sam's Butcher Shop.
Later tonight, Danny lies in critical condition while evidence is mounting against a suspect. Susan Blakely guest stars on Falcon Crest. But first, J.R. has a plan to rid Callie from his life forever. Dallas is next.
Monday after City, will Murphy see the humor when she inspires a sitcom?
Of course, I'd be happy to help you.
The blonde leading the blonde.
Morgan Fairchild guests on Murphy Brown. Then, are designing women macho enough to handle these men?
Macho, we will be.
Nice headlights. Hey, I'm trying.
An all-new Designing Women Monday.